Hey there, Foundation staff. Sherm here, and welcome to Sherm's Declassified Skip Survival Guide. Today we are covering that wacky wizard of whimsy, Dr. Wondertainment. Remember one of the most important laws of the SCP wiki? There is no canon. So we're going to approach this from every angle we can. The good doctor was born in SCP-445, super paper by author Cryogen Chaos. The titular super papers are sheets of paper that take on the properties of the object you shape them into. Fold one into a knife and it will cut like a knife, and so forth. This immediately highlights a huge through-line theme in Dr. Wondertainment products across the wiki. The attempt to make a product that would be anomalously fun for children, or sometimes adults or the Foundation itself, but also has the possibility for unintended or absolutely intended consequences. Dr. Wondertainment and their company have a one-sided relationship with the Foundation. We can't find them, but they certainly know where we are. The Foundation has received cease and desist letters for containing Wondertainment products, recall requests when certain items are broken and could be a danger to containment staff, such as the tale Total Recall, and even gifts for the Foundation, such as SCP-3301, The Foundation, an elaborate Jumanji-esque board game. Now for the million-dollar question, who is Dr. Wondertainment? From the Dr. Wondertainment Hub, we have this cryptic summary.
Dr. Wondertainment may be a company. It may be an individual. It may be an individual that runs a company. Most important, however, is that Dr. Wondertainment is magical and they make toys. Whether they be toys that aren't exactly safe or toys that are beyond anything a kid could ever imagine or want, the very basics of Wondertainment is that they make toys. Interpretations range from being warm-hearted and kind to either straight-up terrible or more than a little misguided. However their intentions or grasp on the world is perceived, they are unarguably tied to children and childlike behaviors.
The most popular headcanon on the wiki likens Dr. Wondertainment to either Willy Wonka or his similarly dressed but far more inappropriate counterpart, the Warden from Super Jail. To quote Cryogen Chaos on the subject, "Whenever it comes to how Wondertainment will react to something, I always envision the good doctor as a fairly psychotic but dangerously intelligent child in an extremely powerful man's body. Think the Warden of Super Jail in the pilot episode. He's the kind of guy who would walk into 682's chamber, narrowly avoid getting bitten, and respond by whacking 682 on the nose with a rolled-up newspaper. And it would fucking work. Only for him, though." There are, of course, a multitude of other possibilities in the wiki. For a simple example, you could look at Wei Zong's tale, The Tinkerer, a fairy tale about an old man who makes magical toys who becomes Dr. Wondertainment. To go a little more grandiose on the subject, we could look at Jorich's mythos. In their Adventures in Capitalism Tales series, we are introduced to Dr. Isabel Helga Anastasia Parvati Wondertainment V, PhD, MD, DD, OD, PsyD, and EngD. She is the current head of the Dr. Wondertainment Company and daughter of Dr. Reginald Filbert Lionel Archibald Westinghouse Wondertainment III, MD, PhD, DDS, Esquire. Through a vision in Adventures in Capitalism 4, we are treated to previous incarnations of Dr. Wondertainment. That's right, folks. In this canon, Dr. Wondertainmentness is passed on in a Time Lord or Avatar-esque fashion because Wondertainment is a force that emanates and manifests from humanity itself. The first Wondertainment was created when humanity gained sapience and created fire. From there, incarnations have included, but are not limited to, original ideas from Jorich, such as a headscarf woman, a woman with a guitar, an old man. Ideas from other incarnations on the wiki, such as a Wild West woman from a planned story of Vince's, Wei Zong's Tinkerer, and the ubiquitous Wonka Warden combo. Pop culture characters who could easily be Wondertainment, such as St. Nicholas and Santa Claus, XBs of Mabel Pines with Waddles from Gravity Falls, Starfire and Silky from Teen Titans, and a gender-flipped Varric from The Legend of Korra. Oh, and Weird Al Yankovic is also Wondertainment. Here's a few more Wondertainment facts that you can keep in your pocket. According to the tale A Fancy Dinosaur by Twisted Gears, Wondertainment is responsible for sending the meteor that killed the dinosaurs. The Good Doctor is also capable of, at least temporarily, containing the power of the Scarlet King, seen in the tale SCP Red, also by Twisted Gears. Finally, Isabel Wondermaker is one of the 7 spear-wielding warriors who slays the Scarlet King in the tale When We Came Home by Jorich. And that's everything. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of Sherm's Declassified Skip Survival Guide. If you like what we're doing on the channel, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit the bell. And if you really like what's going on around here, hit up the Site42 Patreon or the Site42 merch store and support the channel that way. You can also join the Site42 Discord server if you want to venture deeper into Site42 itself. See you next time, Foundation staff. Site42 is able to continue broadcasting and move up to live-action SCP film adaptations due to the support of viewers, subscribers, and especially our patrons. Special shout-out to our site director-level patron, Andre Bechert.